Tom Price out of a job tonight, joining a growing number of members of the administration to get the boot on a Friday, as a matter of fact, and capping a pretty terrible week for President Trump. Here to discuss, CNN political commentators Bakari Sellers, Angela Rice, Alice Stewart, and Andre Bauer. What did I say?
You said Angela Rice.
It's been a while.
That was yesterday.
It did say Rye. My fault. Sorry about that.
Friday,
Price, right. Rice, I got it wrong. Forgive me. But seriously, you guys chuckle when I said a Friday, but I mean, it has been somewhat of a pattern in this administration. What's your reaction to Tom Price, Bakari?
My reaction to Tom Price is quite simple. He should have never been hired. I said this yesterday, and I think it bears repeating, that Tom Price had dubious ethical values at best when he was hired. We always heard about the insider trading allegations. Between 2012 and 2016, he sold more than $300,000 worth of stock that had to do with 40 companies that he had legislation that he either sponsored or co-sponsored. And we found out recently that he took over $1 million worth of flights that we as taxpayers had to pay for. I think that it's more hypocrisy and more hypocritical than anything else. But if you're going to drain the swamp, you just can't swap out the Gators, which is what Donald Trump's been doing.
And we were fighting here with Ben Ferguson last night when he's like, it's not $1 million, when the guy admitted to it and all the numbers pointed to that. So, Andre, I've got to ask you, though. The president has said a number of times that the problem with Price's exorbitant travel is that he didn't like the way it looked. But isn't the problem that it was wrong to use taxpayers' money for luxury travel?
Don, I don't know all the particulars, but from the little bit of news I have, I got to be fair. You know, I criticize when I see people waste government dollars, and to me, it seems like a waste of government taxpayer dollars. And that's probably why he chose to step down today, because he was in the wrong.
Wow.
Amen, church. Amen, church. We'll take it.
We're all stunned. I mean, there is some honesty from someone who is, you know, a Trump supporter. And there hasn't been a lot. People have been, there's
wait
been a
minute.
Lot of.
There's always honesty from me.
Wait, who are you jumping out at, Andre?
There's always this what about it.
I want to be fair to Andre. I think more often than not, as a Trump supporter, every now and then he is a little fair. Andre, you know it's true.
Yeah.
I think the reality of this is, and Bakari's touched on this, Tom Price does have a very challenging history in dealing with his ethics in the House side.
I'm going to let you finish. It's not just that, but because I want to bring up the other. There's the Treasury Secretary, right? There, Steve Mnuchin. There's the EPA Administrator Scott Pruitt, Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke. They haven't been apologetic about it. One of them saying it's kind of BS, right? The Zinke said this story's a little bit BS, but do you think the other cabinet secretary should resign as well?
I think that they definitely have to begin figuring out whether they're going to be an administration of the people, and we talked about this last night.
You called it a culture.
Or I think that was Van that said that, but I did amen it. Yeah. Or one that's elitist, and they continue to demonstrate they're elitist. Donald Trump is also the king of wasting taxpayer dollars. I talked about the golf course issue yesterday. He continues to go to his golf courses. The amount of money that has been spent on Secret Service protection is astronomical and ridiculous. So they have to start at the top. It's not just the cabinet secretaries. They're following their leader.
Yeah. Alice.
One thing you'd mentioned, you know, the president being concerned about the optics of this. Look, I don't think it's as much the optics as it is the ongoing cavalier attitude by cabinet members about frivolous use of taxpayer dollars. Look, they're public servants. They're not members of the royal family. And I think we have, as you mentioned, you know, right there, four or five members, high-ranking members of the administration.
But, Alice, where does that come from? Do you think that comes from the top?
Well, it looks like it's stopping from the top this time. And clearly there is has been a culture that has accepted this. But fortunately, the president says the buck stops here. I was pleased to see tonight that Mick Mulvaney has said, look, we're not going to do this anymore. We're going to have General Kelly oversee the use of private planes by cabinet members. So General Kelly is now going to be the keeper of the federal fleet with regards to travel. And it's unfortunate we've gotten to this point. But look, I think this is a frivolous and an outrageous abuse of taxpayer dollars. But you have to commend the president for saying this is not going to continue anymore. He campaigned on draining the swamp, and this is adding to it. And as bad as this has been, you have to commend the president for saying enough is enough.
Is this billionaire cabinet backfiring, you think? Well, let's give Andre another chance to speak because he was short and sweet this time, which is surprising.
Well, but I was going to say, absolutely. I think it's a good example that they're setting. They're not going to tolerate this. But I think they ought to look at the legislative branch, too. In 1 year, Speaker Pelosi spent over $2 million.
Oh, Andre.
And she's been flying just...
There's that whataboutism that I said.
That's not actually. I think we need to go through this and fact check because a lot of viewers are not aware of the truth. And Andre just laid out a red herring, and so let's fact check it. After 9/11 in 2001, Dennis Hastert, due to security purposes, had to fly on military aircraft. Nancy Pelosi, as the next speaker, had to fly on military aircraft. That fluctuated and shifted around the type of aircraft she used because it had to fly across country. And we also know that many of these red herrings that are coming out, right-wing talking points, are talking about Eric Holder using private airplane or Loretta Lynch or... Even Director Comey. But the problem is that they are supposed to due to security purposes. And so we just need to be honest about this discussion and know that Tom Price deserves to be fired.
When it is warranted. I'll give you the last word.
I was going to say this one point. I think that we would also be remiss if we did not acknowledge the fact that Donald Trump may be a little in his feelings about the fact that Obamacare repeal has not yet passed. Tom Price is also an easy target. So that is why it was so easy to let him go.
He was the guy that was going to do it.
Absolutely.
Is that part of why Price lost his job, Andre?
You know, I don't have any knowledge of that. I hope that's not the reason. I hope it truly is. I hope it truly is for not setting a good example and being a steward and being a steward. Look, I thought
he's double speak.
I know.
No, your Skype is repeating everything you say, so we're having a little fun with you, Andre.
You got hacked by the Russians.
Thank you. Thank you. Unfortunately, I have to go. Thank you all. Have a great weekend. We'll be right back.
Thanks, Tom.